Hello, this is Steve Stannard, and this is Introduction to Lighting. So basic units, all right, how do we measure light? You'll see we have a candle here. Well, why do we use candles? Why do we talk about candles when we're measuring light? Well, when we started to measure light, that's what we were using, right? That was the vernacular. That was the common light source, right? We had candles, and we could actually make much better candles then than we can today. Okay, then you can imagine we had companies that were making candles, sort of like they mentioned the General Electric of making candles, right? But they could make much better candles, and they were much more effective. Now, of course, we only use candles really for decoration. Anyway, it all started with candles. We could make candles that were actually very consistent back then by using the right combination of paraffin and oil, making a wick that's the right thickness out of the right material. You could get candles to burn very consistently and put out a very constant amount of light. So taking this candle, if we were to put the candle in the middle of a 2-foot diameter ball or sphere, if we were to take a knife and say cut a hole in that sphere that's 1 square foot, okay, then the light that shines out through that hole is how we define a lumen. Right, that was the original definition. We've got much more scientific definitions nowadays, but this is where it came from. The nice thing about this, if we use a 2-foot diameter sphere, the radius of that sphere is 1 foot. So we call that in math, we call that a unit sphere. And we have this 1 square foot opening in the sphere. We can translate that whole thing to the metric system and it works the same way. So you can do this with a 1 meter sphere and a 1 square meter hole in it. We still get the same lumen because the proportions are all the same. Lumens are really important to us because they are our most basic measurement of light. All our other lighting metrics are based in terms of lumens. We use lumens on a regular basis to measure the output of lamps. Lumens are not easy to measure. We need a laboratory to measure lumens. So it's not something that you're going to take a light meter and measure the lumen output of a lamp. You're going to determine the lumen output of lamps, for example, by reading the packaging, right? It'll say it on the package. It says so many lumen lamp. Or you may go to a lamp catalog, right? So on the computer, or you may have a paper catalog. I recommend going to the computer. You can actually look up any particular lamp, and it'll tell you the lumen output of that lamp. So here we have a couple of examples. On the left is a typical incandescent lamp that puts out 640 lumens. On the right, we have a compact fluorescent spiral lamp you probably all recognize, and that puts out 600 lumens, which is obviously designed to replace that 640 lumen incandescent lamp. If we take our same candle and mount that candle about a foot away from a flat surface, and then we measure out a square foot on that surface, okay, that surface will be illuminated to 1 lumen per square foot. There'll be 1 lumen landing on each square foot of area, and that is how we define a foot candle. You've probably all heard of foot candles, right? So this is what we call incident light. It's light shining onto surfaces. That surface can be vertical, like we see in this illustration, but more often the surface is a horizontal surface, like on a desktop or on the floor, right? So when we talk about lumens per square feet, we're talking about foot candles. Foot candles are our most common specification metric in the lighting industry. If you ask the question, how much light do I need? The answer will be, you need so many foot candles. How do you determine that? Well, you have to go to the Illuminating Engineering Society, the IES of North America. They're the ones who recommend different lighting levels for different types of environments. So in the IES handbook, you'll see recommendations for offices, for school rooms, for kitchens, for laboratories, industrial facilities, parking lots, you name it. There are foot candle recommendations for all of those. Again, foot candles are lumens per square foot, which means that we're in the English system of measure. We're dealing with feet. If we were to do this in the metric system, we'd be concerned with lumens per square meter. The name for that metric is called a lux, right? A foot candle is roughly equal to 10 lux. So if you happen to see lighting levels specified that look like they're 10 times greater than they ought to be, they're probably in terms of lux. The new version of the IES handbook is measured, all the measurements are illustrated in terms of lux, not in foot candles.